for the last few years. Manufacturers have been chasing the dream of an affordable laptop that converts into a tablet at a moment's notice. A lot of these systems have unforgivable design flaws or drastic price and performance compromises, which has left us pessimistic there's a system that comes anywhere close to that goal. Acer's Switch 10e marries a compact, versatile design with improved storage and a super low price point. Under the hood, the Acer Switch 10e is strikingly similar to the. It carries the same Intel Atom Z3735F, a quad-core chip with a base clock of 1.3 GHz, backed by just 2 GB of RAM. For storage, the Acer 10 has a 64 GB internal SSD, plus a 500 GB data drive in the detachable keyboard. The display is a 10-inch multi-touch panel with a 1.280x800 resolution. This system is similar to another laptop sold by Acer called the Switch 10. The Switch 10e is roughly the same, except with a different processor and added HDD storage in the keyboard, which leads to slight increase in thickness, as well as a case redesign. Both laptops will be sold side by side, so you can choose whether you want to sacrifice thickness for that extra interior storage. Despite our poor expectations for convertibles in general, the older Switch 10 won us over with a sturdy build and solid battery life. Is the updated version an improvement on an already decent system, or a step in the wrong direction? The Switch 10 earns its namesake by packing all of the components behind the display, with the exception of the data drive, so you can remove the keyboard and use it as a tablet. You can reattach the screen forward or backward, so you can use the keyboard as a stand-in hard drive, or not at all, for a small computer. The Switch 10 has an unfortunate weight distribution issue. I found myself in a constant battle that went something like this. I'm sitting at my desk typing away, and decide to reach up and tap something on the screen. Doing so, even lightly, causes the system to flop over onto its back, weighed down by the heavy, detachable display. Setting it back upright doesn't even solve the issue, because the screen is so heavy the hinge extends to its furthest point when it tips. Like,